I talked about top 10 centers in the NHL, and boy were there a lot of requests for me to do a part 2 to that video, so today, as requested, I'll be going through my favorite centers in the NHL from 11 to 20. Now this list, remember, it's not just for this season. I'll be looking at potential, past seasons, and play from this year all together. Before I get started today, I make daily NHL and hockey related content, so if you haven't subscribed to the channel, make sure you do that now, and let's get right into it. Now before we get into my list of 11 through 20 centers, let's just recap my 1 through 10 list. Now at number 1 I had Connor McDavid, number 2 Nathan MacKinnon, 3 Austin Matthews, 4 Leon Draisaitl, 5 Sidney Crosby, 6 Jack Hughes, 7 Elias Pettersson, 8 Alexander Barkov, 9 Jack Eichel, and 10 Braden Point. Now let's get into my list from 11 to 20. At number 20, I think at this point he's already shown that his potential is off the charts. I'll take Connor Bedard in this spot. Some people may have him a bit higher, but to me, he has to have a bit more under his belt before placing him above the other guys that I have on my list. Bedard has dominated with the Blackhawks in his first season and is a clear Calder Trophy favorite, despite missing a substantial amount of time this season with a broken jaw injury. Bedard is a point per game player with 51 points in 53 games played. His hands are elite, hockey IQ is off the charts, and he's quick and dynamic. Bedard has a 12.3 shooting percentage and only 18 points on the power play, meaning he's an incredible 5-on-5 center, which is an important stat for any player to have. Bedard is a minus 37 on the year while averaging 20 minutes of total ice time a game, so the defense is definitely not on his side this year considering the current state of this Blackhawks roster, but that will all improve in time. As the number one overall pick, Connor Bedard is expected to be a franchise generational talent in Chicago, and in his first season he's already living up to that hype. I think placing him at 20 is the perfect spot. He deserves a lot of credit for how well he's transitioned into the NHL, but it's just way too early in his career to really compare him to a lot of the other guys on this list. At number 19, I'm taking Tage Thompson. I will say, at this point, I thought I was going to be able to place him a lot higher on my list, but the drop-off from last season to this season is way greater than I would have thought. Thompson had a breakout year in the 2021-22 season, having 68 points in 78 games played. He then followed that up with a truly incredible year, scoring 47 goals with 47 assists, totaling 94 points in 78 games played. Thompson was a beast last year, but something feels different with his game this year, kind of making you question if that was a fluky season or not. Thompson is a top 20 center and could be higher on a list like this, but with his current stats at the moment, I can't really put him any higher than some of these other guys. 39 points in 57 games played in a season where Buffalo really wanted to take that next step just isn't going to do it for one of your top players. I believe this season is just a down year for Thompson and that he will bounce back from this, but when talking about top centers on any team, you need them to be consistent every year, and this season compared to last, he's not even close. Thompson has a 9.9 shooting percentage and has 14 points on the power play this season. At this point, he's taking more shots than he did last year, but the pucks just aren't finding the back of the net. Thompson's still a fantastic player, but right now I think he's number 19 on my list compared to some of the other guys in the league. At number 18, I'm taking Robert Thomas, a centerman that people don't talk enough about. Thomas was drafted 20th overall back in 2017 by the St. Louis Blues and has been a pivotal piece to their current retool. Thomas had a breakout season in the 2021-22 year and has since been a 60-plus point scorer, with this season being on pace for his highest career point total, having 71 in 67 games played. Thomas this season and last has a faceoff win percentage of 52% while averaging 20-plus minutes of ice time both seasons. Thomas is incredibly dynamic and is such an efficient playmaker. He has the vision to make crisp passes while still having a scorer's touch. He's easily the best player on this St. Louis Blues roster, and with the way he's playing, he'll be a reliable top player for this team as they enter this next era of St. Louis hockey. At number 17, I have Roope Hintz. He's been so good over the past few seasons, and today, let's give him the recognition he deserves for his game. Over the past few years with the Dallas Stars, he's been their best center, and looking at his stats, you can see why so many people value him as a strong center in the NHL. Hintz has two back-to-back 37-goal seasons, and this year, he's going to crack 30 goals again. Hintz has won 52% of his faceoffs last year and was 5th in SAT percentage as well. This year, he has won 55% of his faceoffs, playoffs and has a 17.2 shot percentage, being a very efficient skater for Dallas. Hintz is another hidden gem from the 2015 draft that has grown into a great two-way center. Hintz signed an 8-year 8.5 AAV contract and has outplayed that deal since signing. This player definitely deserves to be in the top 15. I heavily considered placing him number 10 on my last list, but I just feel like a few of these guys have done a bit more to deserve that spot over Hintz. But in the next couple years, watch this guy continue to surge. He's a big part of that Dallas Stars team and will be a huge factor for them in their playoff run this season. At number 16, I'm taking Dylan Larkin. Larkin is the perfect two-way center and can jump all over the sheet playing any style of hockey you need him to. He sees the offensive zone well and can predict a lot of plays that most players typically don't see. He plays the puck strong and has a ton of grit, all while managing to control the pace of play for his team and create space for other guys on the ice. Over the past two seasons, Larkin has been around a 70-point per season player, and this year he was on pace to have a career year had he not missed some time due to injury. Larkin is the exact player you want on your team and fits perfectly with the culture that's been built in Detroit. The Red Wings might make the playoffs this season, and it's truly because of the responsible offensive and defensive play that Larkin brings to that team. I have Larkin in my top 20 because I feel like he just gets underrated since the Red Wings haven't seen a lot of playoff success, but don't let that fool you. He's a great two-way center and is a big part of the culture over in Detroit. At number 15, I have Mark Scheifele. Scheifele has been incredibly consistent for the Jets and deserves a lot of credit for how well he's carried this team over the past few years. Scheifele is a strong player who can pot you close to a point per game while lifting the play of his line mates. Since signing that new extension with Winnipeg, he seems to be playing even better too, which is all you can ask for as a GM. Scheifele has 58 points in 59 games played this year, with a plus 21 and a 15% shooting percentage, which across the board is just better from his stats last season. Scheifele has stepped up big time in Winnipeg, and his stats are only going to get better after adding talent like Monahan and Toffoli at the deadline. Some might have him a little bit lower on a list like this, and I can understand that, but I just really like his game and think he's the perfect top line center for any NHL franchise. Now next up, what a great turnaround this player has had over the past few years. Let me see if you guys can guess this player from his stats. 2021-22 season, 99 points. 2022-23 season, 82 points, and this season, 87 points in 68 games. At number 14, I'm taking JT Miller. Miller has been such a great forward since joining the Vancouver Canucks, and this year he's playing at such a high level, reaping the rewards of this roster's success. Miller is great on the rush and is a strong forward that wins the majority of his draws. Miller is dangerous on the power play, having 42 points this season coming from the man advantage. He's been one of the Canucks' most consistent players over the past few seasons and plays with an edge to his game that's hard to come by in any player. Miller's grit keeps him in plays, and his determination helps him remain among the top scorers in the NHL. In a league that's constantly being filled with superstars, Miller continues to up his game and stay among some of the top mentioned names in hockey. I really like his game and think he's incredibly underrated. He absolutely deserves a top 15 spot. At number 13, let's talk about one of the most consistent two-way forwards of the past generation, Anze Kopitar. When we talk about defensive-minded centermen, Kopitar is always one of the first names brought up, but something that people seem to forget is the offensive playmaking from this guy. Kopitar is 36 years old and has been a consistent 60-plus point skater his entire career. This year, Kopitar has 55 points in 67 games played and is currently leading the Kings to another playoff year. Kopitar has an 18% shooting percentage and a 55% win rate at the faceoff. Even as he enters the final years of his career, Kopitar is still a top 15 center because he can play anywhere on the sheet, and that's such a valuable trait for any center. Kopitar is a solid goal scorer, a great special teams player, and incredibly responsible in all three zones. I would take him as my center any day of the week, and I still believe he's a top center in the NHL. I have him also missing out on the top 10 just because he's a little bit older and the offensive production has slowed down a bit, but don't let that fool you. He's still one of the best centers in the league. Ranking it at number 12 is Sebastian Aho. Aho has excellent form and plays with finesse. He's a fantastic player with 71 points in 64 games played and is on pace for the best season of his career. Aho is finally playing with some great line mates in Gensel and Svechnikov, so you know his numbers are only going to grow even more playing alongside talent like this. Aho has been incredibly consistent, and with the Canes, he has really taken their offense to another level. He also continues to grow as a better defender every season, impacting all areas of the ice for the Hurricanes. Aho is a quick player and can escape high-pressure situations with the great offensive skill that he brings to the table. He has the ability to drive plays and create more offense for his team, which is something that the Hurricanes have really needed since they are more of a defensive-minded team. Aho is a complete player who has really surged over the past few seasons, earning him a spot on my top 15 players list. And ranking in at number 11 is Mika Zibanejad. Zibanejad is a star in New York and a special teams powerhouse. Zibanejad is a very skilled center with great hockey sense and silky smooth mitts. He's a modern day power forward that uses his big frame to out physical defenders on his way towards the net. He's not afraid of traffic and will crash the net on any play, and is also a very responsible defender and plays great in both ends. He's not the fastest skater, but is great with his edges and makes quick cuts using his creative stick handles to help him create space. Mika is in a great place with the Rangers and is thriving on this team, especially over the past few seasons. If you take a look at his numbers in 2021-22, he had 81 points in 81 games played, 22-23, 91 points in 82 games played, and this season he has 58 points in 67 games played, with 34 points coming from the power play. So like I mentioned earlier, he's elite on the man advantage. Mika is incredibly underrated since heading over to New York and deserves a lot of credit for all of the success that the Rangers have seen over the past few seasons. Mika lands at number 11 on my list. I think he's just so good, and I really wanted to put him in my top 10, but I just felt like Braden Point edged him out just a little bit. But if you want to look for a consistent, amazing power play power forward, this is the guy that you want on your team. But this is my top 20 center list from 11 to 20. Be sure to check out my other video on centers from 10 to 1 if you want some in-depth analysis as to why they were chosen over the players on this list. Also, make sure you subscribe to the channel. I see a lot of you guys watch my videos but haven't hit that button yet, so go ahead, it's free, and it will help you see whenever I post videos like this. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one.